Hey there, Terror Talks fans. Are you looking for some other content to listen to? Well, check out our friends at Tales from the Crypt. Join them on a journey into the unexplained, the unnatural, and the unbelievably scary. Every week, they dig through the creepiest and weirdest listener stories, almost too horrifying to be true. This ghoulishly delightful podcast is narrated by two ghoulish girls. Have a story to tell? Questions, comments, contact them at tftcsub@gmail.com. Be sure to check them out and let them know the Terror Talk sent you. Gentlemen, you are listening to another episode of the Terror Talks. We're here on episode 20. I'm your host, Jeremy, and as always, I am so glad to be here with you guys talking about our favorite thing in the world, Halloween, horror, all that good stuff. On today's episode, we are going to be bringing you guys some information about Spirit Halloween. That's right, the store that has swept the nation with its Halloween decor, costumes, makeup, all that fun stuff each and every year. They opened up one of their flagship stores a couple days ago, and not only that, they have also released an epic, and I do mean this when I say it, an epic lineup of animatronics, specifically a line of animatronics entitled the Graveyard Shift Cast. So we are going to be giving you all the ins and outs on that today. But first, before we get into that, we want to keep you guys up to date on all the things going on in the haunt universe. So we're going to jump right into our news segment. So here we go. First up on our news segment today, Lake Hickory Haunts is hiring. That's right, you've heard us talk about Lake Hickory Haunts several times on the show. They are a haunted house, haunted attraction, located up in Lake Hickory, North Carolina. This year will be our first year attending the event, and it is also their 10-year anniversary celebration. So they're celebrating 10 years of fear, 10 years of scaring people. You gotta love that. But they are hiring right now, still hiring. You can go there and apply on their website to work there, be a scare actor, or a makeup artist, anything and everything. They need you. They need your help. So be sure to go out there and apply. You can go to their website to check things out over there, find out how to apply, and get more information on that. Second on our news segment, Universal Studios Halloween Horror Nights seems to be in full swing right now as more decorations are going up in the various scare zones park wide. In several of the rumored scare zones across the park, we have seen a lot, and I mean a lot of decor go up. In the 30th anniversary scare zone, which is located at the very front entrance of the park, you walk into the park, you see this. There has been a giant lighting truss. Well, now that lighting truss has been added to. So now we don't only have a lighting truss. We have lights. We have lighting effects. We have set pieces. We have photo ops. We have banners. We have everything. This scare zone seems to be coming together at a very, very quick pace. And not only that, it seems to solidify the rumor that this will be a 30th anniversary scare zone and will feature all of your favorite Halloween Horror Nights icons from years past. So we should have Eddie, the caretaker, the storyteller, Jack the clown. Fear may even make an appearance. That's my big question is, will we see Fear at this Halloween Horror Nights event? And he's featured on all the artwork, so hopefully we will get him. But that's not all that's happening. Over in the rumored Seek and Destroy scare zone, several set pieces are still going up. They have been going up constantly. It seems that they keep going up. They keep being added to pawn. It's great. We're seeing a lot of great work there. And now we've even seen some signage go up, some banners. And most of them have this interesting little logo that's like an eye kind of overseeing everything. And then some of them have verbiage that says the controller sees all or something to that degree. So I wonder what this could mean. Who is the controller? Is he a new character being brought to Halloween Horror Nights? Maybe he is above everything. Who knows? We will have to wait and find out. Going down a little bit further into the London section, that's where the Harry Potter Wizarding World Diagon Alley is. out on the waterfront, you'll see a couple lighting trusses out there. My best speculation is these will be used for lighting of the event, so more ambiance lightings. And they may even be used in the rumored Lagoon show. So maybe we'll be getting the Marathon of Mayhem back. Maybe we'll be getting the next evolution of the Marathon of Mayhem. Only time will tell. Keep going around the park and you end up in Central Park. See what I did there? In the Central Park scare zone, this is rumored to be the Terra Cruentis scare zone. This is another one of those scare zones that typically at Halloween Horror Nights is one of the biggest and baddest scare zones. There's always so much stuff in there. Very scenic. Lots of people get excited when this scare zone starts to get put together. And right now is no exception either. While there's not a lot of scenic work happening in this area, there is a lot, and we mean a lot of lighting, but there's even more speakers. We have seen a lot of images of just speakers all across the sides. So all we can speculate at this time is that this is going to be a very, very loud scare zone. So we don't know what we're gonna get. We don't know what is gonna be happening there, but there is a lot of speakers there, and we're very excited about that. Finally, in the Hollywood section of the park, this is rumored to be the Eddie scare zone. Many of you know Eddie as the brother of Jack. He's the chainsaw-wielding maniac. He was cut from the event back in 2001 when he was deemed too gruesome to appear at Halloween Horror Nights. But he is going to have his own scare zone. I imagine if I had to speculate or take any guesses here that this is going to be a chainsaw-wielding freak show because it is all about Eddie. He is the chainsaw-wielding maniac. So I guarantee you we're going to be getting some chainsaws in here. In terms of decor, we have seen next to nothing in this scare zone so far. We have not seen any stages go up, any scenery go up, but we have been peering up at the top of buildings, and there are lighting fixtures at the top of them. So we are using that as our speculation to believe that there might be something happening behind the scenes. Finally, one last thing we want to talk about. That's going to do it for the scare zones around the park. But Universal's social media has been hyping up the event as much as they can right now. And they have released a type of advent calendar, if you will. But obviously it's not for advent, it's not for Christmas, because we're not even near that yet. It is for Halloween Horror Nights. They released it the other day, and it is a countdown. It is 31 doors leading up to September 3rd, the official start date of Halloween Horror Nights. We don't know what the purpose of this is. Is it just a hype thing? Is it a way to announce everything in a quicker fashion or a different fashion, because this is the 30th anniversary? Maybe they want to do something a little different with how they announce things. We don't know, but you can go see that on their social media. It's really kind of cool the way they're doing it, and it's definitely getting people excited. Last but certainly not least, the Hall-O-Scream events. These are the events happening at Busch Gardens and SeaWorld. The Orlando and the Tampa versions of this event have been steady releasing houses and things like that. We're not going to talk really at all about it, but we did want to notify you about this, that they are still going ahead as of now with their event as planned, and they are still releasing things. We will be doing a special episode coming up on the most recent announcements there. But that is going to do it for us today on the news. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to dive right in with the main topic of today's episode. So, recently on Saturday, July 31st, the 31st, how about that? Spirit Halloween opened its flagship store in Egg Harbor Township, New Jersey. This was a major, major media event for a lot of people. A lot of people attended the event. It was very cool. I really wish we could have been there. That would have been really awesome. The mayor was there. Everyone seemed to show up and brought their Halloween spirit with them. And for me, I'm using this as the official start to the Halloween season. We are officially in full swing now. Things are beginning to get underway. And this was the big, significant beginning to it. We've been waiting for it. So now we have it. Spirit Halloween has officially opened the flagship store for the 2021 season. And in the store, there was no shortage of animatronics, costumes, makeup, You name it, they got it. These guys are the best in the business when it comes to Halloween costumes, decor, all that fun stuff. I use them every year when I want to do my little at-home haunted houses. Maybe we'll get to do it this year. Maybe that'll be something we get to talk about. Who knows? But they had everything, and they released some new things for the 2021 haunt season, and that's what we're going to be talking about with you guys today. So they didn't just release decor. They released a line, a brand new line of animatronics entitled the Graveyard Shift. These are life-size animatronics of various origins. They released several of them, most of which are on sale now. You can buy them, and a couple of them are coming soon, so you can't get them just yet, but they are on their way, and we're very excited about this. And so we're going to talk to you about each of them, just give you a brief kind of summary on them, and just, you know, discuss it a little bit, you know? So, first up, the first member of the Graveyard Shift is Wacky Mole. The carnival is finally back in town. The main street is full of the smell of funnel cake, hot dogs, the sound of kiddie rides, and the screams of terrified children running for their lives. Wacky Mole is rolling back into town with his hammer and a wicked game after an extended stay at the Big Top Rest Home for Nervous Clowns. Be warned, it's free to play, but the prize is escaping with your life. The fan favorite Wacky Mole animatronic is so excited to make its return to Spirit Halloween. Wacky Mole will turn your home into the ultimate creepy funhouse and have everyone shook this Halloween with his rotating waist, light up LED lights, and sinister smile. Wacky Mole even features blacklight responsive details that will have him glowing in any blacklit setting. These are some of the things that Wacky Mole says. Bad Halloween costumes make me crazy. They make me want to pummel things with my hammer. Yes, I think I'm going crazy again. Step right up, boys and girls. Who's next to get walloped by a hammer, hmm? Ha ha ha, who will be the first on their block to say, Wacky Mole clubbed me over the head. I just love hitting you bozos with my hammer. You better watch out or I'm going to womp you over the head too. Oh, please, come a little closer. Hmm? Couple little things about him. He is an animated animatronic. He is infrared sensor activated. Compatible with any step pad. Multi-prop remote compatible. It has an adapter type of a 5.9 volt 1.5A, and that is included. The cord length is 9.8 feet. He is 69 inches tall, 23.62 inches wide, and 34 inches deep. And he weighs about 15.5 pounds. So, this animatronic is one that is really kind of creepy to look at. So, I'm not one who's scared of clowns. Clowns don't bother me. They bother my brother big time. Maybe I'll have to buy this and just put it in his room for him. Comment in the comment section below. Should I get this and put it in my brother's bedroom? But I think this is a really neat animatronic. You don't see things like this too often. And, you know, a lot of haunted houses don't necessarily use animatronics like this because they have real people. But this is one that you could actually use in a haunted house. Very easily, actually. Because of its compatibility, and you're able to use it with different things. You can make it so people can step on it and trigger his responses and make him come to life. He has that glow-in-the-dark blacklight ability as well. You know, it's all these things that really, really work to the advantage for a haunted house or even an at-home haunt. Maybe you don't have actors for your haunted home. This guy can make it happen. And, I mean, he's just creepy looking. He really is. Like, I would actually be scared to see him. Like, if you had the lighting done just right, it would look perfect with this guy, especially with the black light effect, because if you did it in a black lit kind of room with the neon lighting and such, and he's just kind of standing there in the corner, you wouldn't be able to tell if he was real or not. That's the beauty of these animatronics, is they do a great job with them, making them look just creepy and realistic. So if you want to buy Wacky Mole, he is $219. That's right, 219 big ones. So, be sure to add Wacky Mole to your haunted house this year. Up next, we have Buzzsaw. Bill Buzzsaw Jackson never had much luck in the squared circle. His lumberjack routine just didn't cut it with fans of the local wrestling circuit. Well, Buzzsaw finally found his calling when he decided to swap his real hands for some twisted new upgrades that were sure to turn the tables in the ring. Unfortunately for Buzzsaw, the fans spent more time running for their lives than watching him wrestle. Now, instead of body slamming his opponents, he's busy racking up victims and running from the law. This Buzzsaw animatronic features a large mallet on one hand and a terrifying buzzsaw that spins on the other. His LED light-up eyes and left and right turning torso will have all your guests running in fear this Halloween. So, some of the sayings that he has are, "I've got a hammer and I hammer in the evening all over this place. Ha ha ha. Did you see that? Zing! I saw that. Ha ha ha. Don't forget to duck, or you're a dead duck. You ever have an itch you just can't scratch? Ha. Here, let me help you with that. Think fast. Zing. You have to be faster than that. You need to be cut. Zing. Down to size. Looks like you need a little trimming. A nip here, a tuck there. Ha ha. You'll be perfect in no time." He is animated, infrared sensor activated, step pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible. Same type as adapter as the other one, 9.8 feet. He is 72 inches tall, 72 inches wide, and 44 inches deep. And he weighs 24.4 pounds. He is made of metal, fabric, and plastic.
So, Buzzsaw is definitely something else, to say the least. Just looking at him is just like creepy as all get out. I mean, he's literally a giant man with a mallet for one hand and, like his name says, a buzzsaw for another. And I mean, if I ran into this thing, I would be really creeped out by it. I mean, there is no questioning it. I would not, you know, think twice about seeing him and running the other way. So he's definitely a creepy looking thing. You can tell that parts of him are definitely more animatronic than human, so he's not quite as realistic looking as some of the other ones that we'll look at today. But, I mean, he still does look good, and, you know, his stature towering over you, definitely if you saw him in the right lighting in a corner of a room or whatever, it would be enough to scare the living crap out of you. Like, I would still be scared, and especially if you activated it and he just started moving around and talking to you. Like, that would be enough to make a grown man scream and cry. Or maybe not scream and cry, but definitely would be enough to scare him. So, I mean, he is definitely an interesting character. Definitely a scary character. If you would want to buy the Buzzsaw animatronic, he is $279. Up next, we have Mr. Howell. So, Mr. Howell, Bert Howell never thought his love of hunting would become his curse. An experienced marksman, Bert spent weeks camping and trekking through the Northwest Territories, hunting wild game until nature decided it had enough of his trophy hunting ways. Late one night, under the full moon, the Wolf King descended from its mountain and left Bert with a single bite. He considered himself lucky only until the next full moon, when the change began. Now, every month, Bert transforms into a ravenous werewolf and is hunted like an animal as he tries to survive until morning. Mr. Howell will terrify your guests this Halloween with his ferocious head movements and rising arms. Once he tilts his head back to show off his light-up LED eyes, gnarly teeth, and huge jaw, you better hope you're not in biting range. So this animatronic doesn't have any sayings or anything like that, but he does have growling and howling noises, which fits his name, Mr. Howell. He is animated, he is infrared sensor activated, step pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible, has the same type of adapter as the other ones, 9.8 feet cord length. He is 84 inches tall, 26.1 inches wide, and 18.5 inches deep. And he weighs 34 pounds and is made of metal, fabric, and plastic. So, Mr. Howell. So, this is definitely one, just looking at it, it's definitely a little more cartoony. You can tell it's a little more cartoony. It's meant to be an animatronic. It's not meant to be too serious. But it's still tall enough that it would elicit a scare in a dark room. It would definitely be a good piece of scenery to have in, you know, maybe a Wolfman haunted house or something like that, or maybe a haunted house where you are traveling through the woods, if you will. Like, that would be a very good use for them. You know, having the growling and howling noises, those are always very off-putting noises that you can hear, not just in a haunted house, but anywhere. You know, if I heard growling or howling noises, you know, I would get really off-put by that, because clearly there is a type of danger that is lurking nearby, so that would be enough for that. You know, his stature is very tall, so that in and of itself is enough to scare a person. And like I said, the only issue I have is it does look a little cartoony by the picture. And I mean, I get it. You can only do so much with, you know, animatronics. There's not a whole lot you can do with them. But you could try to make them a little bit more believable. And this one just misses the bar just a little bit. So, I mean, it is what it is. You do what you can and you go about your life. And like I said, you don't have to buy it. If you want to buy it, you can. If you want to buy Mr. Howell, he is $300, $299.99. Up next we have Grimm. Watch out when the sun dips below the horizon and the dark blanket of night lays across your sleepy little town, because Grimm and his tortured undead brethren rise to stalk the lives of the living. Cursed to walk the night for eternity, reaping misfortune and ghastly dread to anyone unlucky enough to cross their path. Don't be fooled by their wicked sense of humor, or else while you are laughing, you might find that your funny bone, along with the rest of your skeleton, ends up part of their army, forever. This grim skeleton animatronic will send a chill down your spine this Halloween, while using a combination of six different servos motors to move the different parts of his body, including his arms, torso, head, and eyes. Mr. Grimm's head movements was programmed to turn side to side, nod up and down, and tilt left to right, all at the same time to create a lifelike, complex movement. Three servo motors are used to control the eye movement, allowing the eyes to realistically turn up and down from side to side as he spits some bone-chilling phrases. And those phrases are, "Your host is not here right now. They're busy burying something in the backyard, but we'll have loads of fun while they are gone. The night is young, and I'm ready to party. Are you? You best be careful where you tread on this dark night. You don't know who you will run into. Creatures and creepy crawlies lurk out from every shadow. Why, I was just hiding in your closet with the other skeletons. Perhaps we let them all out for some fun. Ah, you look like death warmed over, my friend. This is good. Soon there will be enough of us, and we will terrorize the living until we own this night. Are you with me? Tonight is ours." And just like all of the other animatronics, he is animated, infrared, sensor-activated, step-pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible, and it has the same adapter and things of that nature as well. So, Grimm. What do we think of Grimm? He is something else, that's for sure. Much like everything else, he has been more or less the poster child, if you will, for this whole graveyard shift cast. So that's kind of neat. He's really, like, just looking at him, he's a skeleton. I mean, there's not much to a skeleton. There's not a whole lot you can do with skeletons to make them look, I guess, evil. Just because, I mean, it's literally all bone. But this one actually looks pretty good. I mean, everything is there. He has these glowing eyes that are really creepy looking. I mean, it's really a nice piece of work they've done here. And I think it looks like a really neat animatronic to have. I know I would love to have it, you know, maybe for like a costume party kind of thing. You know, have them at the Halloween party telling jokes at the front door as people were coming in. That might be a neat little thing. So yeah, I mean, he's definitely a cool piece. I would definitely want to keep him. He is 70.8 inches tall, 28.3 inches wide, and 25.6 inches deep, and weighs 14 pounds, and he weighs $279. Up next, we have the ghost with the most. He is one of my favorite people in the world. He's awesome. We love him. He's funny. He's goofy. He's vulgar. He's everything. Beetlejuice. Need a scare done right? Say Beetlejuice three times and the perfect man for the job will appear. A true undead professional, Beetlejuice's bold personality and even bolder style will freeze anyone in their tracks. His over-the-top presence and rude jokes are enough to overwhelm any person, living or dead, and once summoned, getting rid of him is not always so simple. Just ask the Maitlands. After failing in his plan to escape the Netherworld and roam the world freely by marrying Lydia Dietz, he was sent to the waiting room for the deceased, where he waits for the next unlucky person to summon him to Rome once again. Yeah, but he won't be so creepy then, because he's got the shrunken head. A little joke for those who've seen the movie. Consider yourself unlucky once this Beetlejuice animatronic comes to life. You won't know what to say once his torso begins to turn from side to side, and he begins to taunt you with his hilarious phrases from the movie. So some of those awesome phrases include, I'm feeling a little anxious, if you know what I mean. It's been about 600 years, after all. I wonder where a guy, an everyday Joe like myself, can find a little action. Now, turn the juice and see what shakes loose. Woo, thank you. That's why I don't do true shows anymore. I won't do them. Hey, these aren't my rules. Come to think of it, I don't have any rules. I attended Juilliard. I'm a graduate of Harvard Business School. I traveled extensively. I lived through the Black Plague, and I had a pretty good time doing that. I've seen The Exorcist about 167 times, and it keeps getting funnier every single time I see it! Say it once, say it twice, third time's a charm. Just say it! It's showtime. You know, you look like somebody I can relate to. Maybe you could help me get out of here, you know, because I gotta tell you, this dead thing, it's just too creepy. See, here's my problem. I got these friends I said I'd meet, and it's the kind of thing where I have to be there in person. So, could you help me get out of here? This Beetlejuice animatronic is animated, infrared sensor activated, step pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible. Different adapter type, 6V2A adapter. Cord link is 9.8 feet, and he is 70 inches tall, 30 inches wide, and 22.8 inches deep. Weighing 17.3 pounds. So, say it once, say it twice, say it three times. Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice. We love Beetlejuice. He is one of our favorite people in the world. He is funny. He's vulgar. He's scary at times. He's awesome. We love him to death. And I'm so excited that they made an animatronic of Beetlejuice. Like, that's really, really neat that they were able to do that. And on top of that, they didn't just make a Beetlejuice animatronic. They made an animatronic that includes all of his phrases. Like, what more could you ask for? I mean, that's pretty impressive. Now, where I do take issue, because, you know, we got to find some issues somewhere. The animatronic itself looks excruciatingly cartoony. Like, you can definitely tell that he is a cartoon. And that's a little disappointing, in my opinion. So, that for me, is a little bit of a deal breaker, just because it does look a little cartoony. But, I mean, he'd be kind of cool, I guess, to have as, like, maybe one of those little greeters when he comes, when you get into a haunted house, maybe. I don't know. Who knows? That's my big issue with him, is how tacky he seems to look. He definitely, like, honestly, his eyes look like he has seen some stuff in his life. And, like, they're just, like, literally big old bulgy eyes. So, I do have a problem with that. But I try to give a little leeway because, I mean, you can't make an animatronic look just like a real person. I mean, you can, but, you know, that's something that, like, theme parks do. Not people like this. Not Halloween stores. So, I mean, maybe in person it looks a little bit better. But I can definitely tell you from the pictures, it's definitely a little, just not great for me, to be honest with you. Not too great. But, like I said, we'll give him a chance. We'll let it go. We're not going to dwell on it too much. If you want to purchase the Beetlejuice animatronic, It is going to run you $279. Now, before we take a break, we've got one more for you, and it is the Ghostface animatronic. So, better watch your back when Ghostface is in town. And don't even think about picking up that telephone. The master of stalking prey loves to manipulate his victims before sneaking up and landing a deadly strike with his hunting knife. His motivation is unclear, as you never know who could be donning the Ghostface mask next. He lurks and hides in the shadows with his black robe and moves as swiftly as the cold wind as he prepares to go on his next killing spree. Be careful where you run this Halloween, because you never know when this Ghostface animatronic will pop out from behind a corner and give you a terrifying jump scare. This animatronic pops out from both left and right, making him perfect to place anywhere in your home. He is animated, infrared sensor activated, step pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible. The adapter type is also a 6V2A. Cord length is 9.8 feet, and he is 62.6 inches tall, 15.75 inches wide, and 16.15 inches deep, and weighs 8.6 pounds. So this is the Ghostface animatronic. So looking at it, I mean, you know, I do have to wonder a little bit, was it really necessary to make an entire animatronic of Ghostface? I mean, I can't imagine it's going to do a whole lot for people. I can't imagine this is going to be a big seller. Maybe it will, because it's more, it's one of the cheaper ones, more on the cheap side. I know looking at the mask isn't really, you know, it's supposed to be, well, I guess looking at it now, it does look pretty real. It looks like the actual mask. From one of the images, it looks very cartoony, so that's where I took a little bit of issue. I'm not going to lie, his stature looks really skinny. Like, he looks like Ghostface had, like, an extreme diet. And so that's a little weird, to say the least, because he looks very skinny. Looks like he could eat a sandwich or two or seven. But, you know, it is what it is. We do what we can, and, you know, they can't all be winners, I guess you could say. Some can, but they can't all be. So that is the Ghostface animatronic. If you want to purchase that, it is $129. All right, we are going to take a short little break, but we will be right back. Hey there, Terror Talk fans. Are you looking for a new way to let your voice be heard? If so, check out our friends at Anchor. Anchor is a one-stop shop for creating your very own podcast. They offer editing tools to create your podcast, which include your audio, listener audio, unique transitions, and custom advertisements. In addition, they'll also help you distribute your podcast to other listener sources, such as Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many others. With this unique app, you also have the chance to get paid for your podcast by simply placing ads for various sponsors in your videos. Best part of it all? It is 100% free. Anchor does all the work for you and makes podcasting as simple as turning on a light. Download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. That's ANCHOR.FM. Whether you're new to podcasting, doing it as a hobby, or hosting a professional show, Anchor is the place for you. And we're back, ladies and gentlemen, on this episode of the Terror Talks. Today, we're talking about Spirit Halloween's latest announcement, their newest cast of animatronics. Before the break, it talked about Ghostface, Beetlejuice, Grimm, Mr. Howell, Buzzsaw, and Wacky Mole. Now we're going to be talking about some more. We're going to be talking about, first off, the Night Stalker. You work from sunup to sundown, tending the fields, babying your crops and livestock to eke out a living. Then one morning, you wake up to find dead birds strewn across your fields, and all your wheat crops smashed and bent over, and you swear to yourself that your scarecrow is smiling now. The other farmers tell you stories about missing chickens and uprooted vegetable crops. You chuckle and think it's a good thing that he's stuck to that wooden stake. But just in case, you start sleeping with your favorite machete next to the bed.
The Night Stalker animatronic has light-up LED eyes and moves its head from side to side while making creepy laughing sounds. So this product, much like a couple of the other ones, does not have any particular sayings because he is nothing more than a mere scarecrow. But he does have some maniacal laughing and crow sounds that go along with him. This animatronic is, much like all the other ones, he is animated, he is infrared sensor activated, step pad compatible, multi-prop remote compatible, has the same type of adapter, 9.8 cord length, 74 inches tall, 43.5 inches wide, 14.5 inches deep, and he weighs 10.14 pounds. So, the Night Stalker. So this thing's actually kind of creepy looking, honestly. I mean, it definitely, like, it's got this really eerie looking smile to it. It's definitely something that, like, if you had it set up in your yard, this was definitely more of a yard kind of hunt piece that you would want to use. I couldn't see it being in a haunted house. Maybe in one of your, like, local haunted houses, if it had, like, an outdoor section, he'd be great out there with some fog around his ankles, that type of thing. It would actually look really neat. He's got these glowing yellow eyes that are just eerie as all get out. And, I mean, he looks like a real scarecrow, but he's got, like, the smile. Like, let's just talk about that smile. That smile is just creepy as all get out, y'all. So that's the Night Stalker animatronic. If you want to purchase him, he is $179. Up next, we have Henry Hustle. Pick a card, any card. Henry guarantees you will end up with the dead man's hand. He wasn't always so cruel, but when the circus left town with his money and bag of tricks, he snapped. It didn't help that the ringmaster ran off with Mrs. Hustle. Now the deck is stacked against anyone unlucky enough to play a hand with him, because while you are following the queen, his daughter Harriet is busy robbing you blind, or worse. Try your luck against Henry Hustle this Halloween, and you have no choice. This Henry Hustle animatronic is always ready for a performance, with his white light up LED eyes and arms that move up and down to reveal your card before popping his head up for the ultimate jump scare. So this product does have some sayings. Time for a trick, as his hand pops out. Remember this card, his hand retracts. It'll be the last thing, hand pops out and evil head pops up, the booming loud evil voice you'll ever see. Step right up and pick a card, as his hand pops out. It seems you've picked, hand retracts. Hand pops out and evil head pops up, and he says in a booming loud evil voice, the card of death. Wanna play a hand, as his hand pops out? Stakes are high and you may lose, his hand retracts. Then his hand pops out again and his evil head pops up and he says in a booming loud voice, your life. So this animatronic features all the same things as the other ones. He is 70.8 inches tall, 28.3 inches wide, 25.6 inches deep, and weighs 14 pounds. So, this guy's kind of interesting to just look at. Like, he actually looks like he could be a real clown. Like, it's really kind of creepy looking. It looks like a real person, and if I didn't know any better, I'd say a real person put on a clown costume and was standing there looking at me. So good on Spirit Halloween for making one like that. I really think that it's real creepy looking. It definitely would work if you had like a clown room in a haunted house or something. Like, he would be very good in there, or even at a Halloween party where you're just trying to get a couple jump scares. I feel like this clown would even scare my brother, because, and my brother, he's not, like, deathly scared of clowns, but he is somewhat afraid of clowns, and I feel like this guy would actually scare him a little bit, so, who knows, maybe we'll buy him this year and set him up in his room or something. But if you want to buy Henry Hustle, he is $229. Now, we have two that are coming soon. They are not up for grabs yet, but they are coming soon. As of the time we're recording this, they're not up for grabs. By the time we post it, maybe they will be. We will find out soon enough. So the first one is the caretaker. When someone calls for the caretaker, you best stay out of his path. Hospitality isn't on his mind. When you see his gnarled visage dragging a tombstone through your streets, you best hope he is not coming for your loved ones, because the caretaker is no ordinary gravedigger. He arrives for those whose sins are so dark only he can be trusted to safely bury them along with the body before they escape and come for us all. This caretaker animatronic will make the perfect addition to any haunted cemetery. This Halloween with his yellow LED light-up eyes and arms that move up and down to lift his shovel. Better hope the hole he's digging next isn't for you. So he has a couple sayings. There you are. I've been looking for you all night. I've come for you in regards to a serious matter. A very grave matter. Dad humor. There is no escape. No one will hear your cries for help. The earth will fill your lungs as you try to scream. Buried alive. Take a good look at my face. It will be the last thing you ever see. Right before I seal your coffin for your eternal slumber. Sweet dreams. So this animatronic comes with all the same things as the other ones, and he is 58 inches tall, 54 inches wide, 68 inches deep, and weighs about 20 pounds. And there is no price point at this time for him because he is coming soon. But this guy is actually really creepy looking. He would be real creepy to have standing in like the corner of a cemetery scene, whether it be a haunted house or an at-home haunt. It definitely would be effective because he looks like he could be real. Because the way they've designed it with putting like a hood over his head, it would definitely make it difficult to see what exactly you're looking at. Like, it would actually be really creepy. And then, you know, looking at the detail work on the face itself, like, it actually looks like they put a lot of detail into making it. And then, of course, you've got glowing yellow eyes, because why not? You gotta have those glowing eyes. But that's the caretaker. That is one that is a... really kind of creepy looking. I'd love to have him. And finally, we have one last one coming soon. And this one is a personal favorite of mine, much like Beetlejuice and Scream. This one is another one of those favorites that I love, and I would love to have him as part of a haunted house. This is Shorty from the Killer Clowns from Outer Space film. After a strange glowing object from space crashed down onto Earth just outside of Crescent Cove, evil clownish aliens known as the Clowns emerge to have their twisted fun and wreak havoc this Halloween. Leaving remains of popcorn and cotton candy cocoons, these killer clowns have plenty of tricks up their sleeves. Shorty is one of the wildest of the bunch. With his bright yellow clown suit, wacky green hair, and his creepy red nose and smile, equipped with a cotton candy ray gun and a giant boxing glove, he'll have no problem knocking you silly. Now, Shorty and his fellow killer clowns roam the streets in search of volunteers for their next very special performance. Once you get a ticket to this killer clown circus, there's no guarantee you'll make it out alive. You'll need to watch your back this Halloween. Once Shorty comes to life with his swaying head movement and up and down moving arms, once you hear him play his intergalactic sounds and you add his removable boxing glove, he'll be ready for some killer clown action. So he's animated, infrared, sensor-activated, step-pack compatible, multi-prop remote compatible. Adapter type is a 6-volt 2A, and cord length is 9.8 feet. He is 60 inches tall, 18.9 inches wide, 14.17 inches deep, and he weighs 20.94 pounds. So this is an animatronic that I would love to have, and he really does look like he could be real. Like, this has to be one of the most realistic-looking animatronics I've ever seen in my life. I'm really shocked at how real he looks. Like, he looks like the actual Shorty from the Killer Clowns film. Like, that's pretty awesome to me. I would absolutely buy him if I could. I would have him standing out on my front porch on Halloween. I feel like that would be an absolute awesome thing to see. I mean, he looks real, y'all. Like, he looks like the real thing. It's hard to believe that it's just an animatronic. I just showed it to my brother, and he was just like, oh, wow. He couldn't believe that it actually looks real. So, in my opinion, this has to be one of the best ones that Spirit Halloween did. And they did a couple clown ones, but this one, I'd say, is the most realistic one. And just because of how realistic it is definitely one of the scarier ones. But there's no price for him yet because he is still just coming soon. But he will be released soon enough, and when we have some price points on him, we will let you guys know. But that is going to do it for us today on episode 20 of the Terror Talks. We want to thank you guys so much for joining us as we discuss Spirit Halloween's newest animatronic releases, The Graveyard Shift. Be sure to go check out Spirit Halloween, whether it be on their website or if you have one in your local town. Go check them out for all your Halloween decor, costumes, makeup, etc. They have everything. They are the best in the business. If you enjoyed today's episode, be sure to go and rate, comment, and subscribe below. Let us know what you thought. Let us know what you didn't like. Let us know what you want to hear, what you want to see. We are happy to help you guys out. If you liked what you heard or have some suggestions, or maybe you just want to reach out and shoot us a message, you can send us one at any of our social medias. You can comment on our video, or you can shoot us an email to theterrortalks@gmail.com. Be sure to like us on our social medias. We are on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Just look up The Terror Talks. You will find us. You can listen to us on many of our streaming platforms. We are on Spotify, Anchor, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, and so much more. Go check all of those out. Go check out our friends over at Tales from the Creeped. This is a podcast that covers all things paranormal, supernatural, extraterrestrial, interdimensional, and just downright unexplainable. The two girls on this podcast are absolutely awesome. We love working with them. We love getting to listen to their episodes. We never miss one. So go check them out. Let them know the Terror Talk sent you. Also, go check out our friends over at the Unofficial Universal Orlando Podcast, or UUOP for short. They are covering all things Universal Studios, specifically Orlando, but they are also covering other Universal parks as well and various topics. If you like them, you can check out their sister podcast, the Rush of Fear Podcast. That is Rush of Fear. They are covering all things Halloween Horror Nights. We absolutely love everything that they put out. We never miss an episode from them either. We try to keep an eye on them in case we miss something. We can always count on them to have something put out there so we can get the information out to you guys. Go check them out. They're awesome. Finally, go check out our friends over at the Theme Park Duo. They are over on the West Coast covering all things Hollywood, California, all that fun stuff. And they'll be covering all the things with HHN Hollywood, Mickey's Not So Scary Halloween Party over in Disneyland, Not Scary Farm, but they also do things during the regular year. They are a theme park podcast, so the Halloween part is just a bonus for us. So, but give them a check out on all of their theme park stuff and various themed entertainment options. Finally, we want to thank you for being a loyal listener and allowing us to do what we do. We could not do this without you. Without you, there would be no show, and we wouldn't be able to do this. So thank you guys so much for listening, and we hope you will continue to support the show, continue to check us out each week. We are trying to put content out as often as we possibly can. Sometimes our schedule is a little bit skewed, so we might not always post on a consistent date, but you can almost rest assured that we will have an episode out every single week. It may just vary on what day it is, and sometimes we will even post 2 to 3 episodes in a week. We're trying to get you guys everything that you possibly can to be satisfied, so we hope that we are doing everything we can, and we hope you enjoy it. So, we hope you enjoyed our episode of The Terror Talks, where we discuss the new animatronics released by Spirit Halloween. That is going to do it for us today, so thank you guys for sticking around, and until next time, be safe out there, don't text and drive, and be excellent to each other. Take care, guys.